somehow all the things we observe in the world have these really simple explanations that we can represent as mathematical facts. So somehow the Born rule is sitting inside the Pythagorean theorem or some complex generalization of it. We often think that somehow getting more stuff about this into this tells us the theory is better. That's a sort of a very strange metaphysical thing to believe, that reality has to be consistent mathematically, and yet it's so far it's done quite well. I'm going to talk about some work that I've done with Scott Viteri at CMU, which is that there is a separate thing in mathematics. There's not just the way that mathematics appears in reality, the fact that it's pretty good at telling us the lengths of things, but also that mathematics involves proofs. We come to know mathematical facts not by observations in the world, but by reasoning about them. And there's a distinction between these two things. We can know the Pythagorean theorem without knowing that it is true. So my question is, how does the structure of mathematical knowledge affect physical reality? Not the structure of mathematics, not, let's say, some fact about Lie algebras, but some fact about how we come to prove that Lie algebras have certain properties. So if that's not nuts enough for FQXi, I don't know. So it turns out you can prove things with a computer. You don't do it with set theory, because set theory is undecidable. You do it with type theory, which is something Russell worked out in order to get around the undecidability problems. This is a little proof here that 8 is even. One of the nice things about type theory is that you have to sort of assert that things are sitting in the type that you think they are. So a chunk of this proof says, for example, 4 is a thing that I've correctly identified, that there is something of type integer that I call 4, and it's the fourth successor of 0. This is another proof here. Each of these nodes is some kind of assertion, some kind of proposition. This is something that Scott did for us. It's the proof that every number is equal to itself. If anything has gone wrong in this proof, then we're in trouble. Scott proved it in a very strange and elaborate way. Any case, we've been running proofs of some of the major theorems through our system, looking at the network of relationships that obtain between the propositions. One of the things that we realize about mathematical proofs is if we think of them as just a chain of deductions, if we've made an error at any point, the whole thing falls apart. So if you have an epsilon, no matter how tiny of error, then you're probably not going to believe any useful theorem in the world, because the chance that you've not made a mistake in every single point is going to zero really quickly. The way we think about this is in a kind of icing model way. I believe my axioms in part because I believe the things I derive from them. Anyway, here's the Pythagorean theorem. There's 20,000 lemmas that you need to prove the Pythagorean theorem, and there's 100 axioms. Scott tells me, so actually I said that many axioms, he hasn't quite bottomed out, we ran out of memory. So good luck with the four-color theorem. Sitting out here are the Tarski axioms. Tarski put Euclidean geometry on a sound footing with a set of sort of very basic axioms that characterize our intuitions about physical space. I spent time at the Santa Fe Institute. There is indeed a power law relationship here for how many things any particular assertion depends on. It doesn't look like how software dependencies work, interestingly. It's actually the complete reverse of that process. So there are a small number of things upon which everything depends, and lots of sort of trashy ones that you only need once or twice. The index of that power law is -2 across all the theorems that we've tested, including the ancient Greeks and the 19th century. In any case, here are some things we've discovered so far. So there are many structures, there's many structural properties of mathematical theorems that seem to be shared across a wide range of things we wish to assert. The other thing we've noticed is that there's very strong modularity in these systems. So that I can disbelieve, for example, a chunk of the foundations, and yet that won't affect my certainty about things further up the hierarchy, and vice versa. So I can believe in the integers, but not believe in the reals, for example. All right. Thank you.